Hello, this is Randy with Excel for Freelancers, and today I'm going to show you just how to use a pop-up time picker inside your own workbook. And if you haven't had a chance to download the time picker yet, you can go ahead and I'll leave a link down below in the description so you can get it from there. All right, let's get started. And basically what you're looking at here is the pop-up time picker, and if you click on the time, you'll see the time picker pop up, and then basically it allows you to select any specific time, AM or PM, and then you can also click on the settings here, and you can select the intervals, whether it's 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, as well as choose a specific theme here. All right, so we'll go ahead and leave it here, and basically to get this into your own application or your own workbook. It's quite simple, and we just have to do a few things to make sure that we get it securely into our own workbook. The first thing you want to do is you want to make sure that macros are enabled for your time picker workbook. And you can do that via the enable macros. You'll see that pop up. It'll pop up here, as well as if you have a developer tab. You want to make sure that the macros are enabled because this workbook does use macros. So that's an important part. And then what we'll do is we want to go ahead and put it in, let's say, a new workbook. So we'll click on new workbook. And here I have a new workbook. And let's say we want the time picker to pop up in let's say, C3. Okay, so we're going to have it, we want it in C3, this one. That's where we want our new time picker pop up to show up. Okay, so in our new workbook, so we'll revert back to our existing workbook. And what we want to do is we want to select, obviously, in this case, K8 to display the time picker, and select on the entire shape. Once again, click here and then select on one of the outer edges, anywhere on the outer edges where you see that plus symbol, and you click there, and that will actually enable that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to copy. We can do Control C, or we can simply right click and copy. Okay, and now we're going to switch back to our new workbook. We can use Control Tab to switch back, and we're going to paste that anywhere into the new workbook, anywhere. So we're just going to paste it here, or Control V will get you there. Okay, now we go back to our original workbook, and what we want to do is we then want to open the developers tab, and if you don't have this tab here, you can press Alt 11 in order to open the developers section, or we can also, you can go under here under properties and options. We can select the customize ribbon here, and then you can see the developer here. We can select that here by selecting that, the developers tab will show up. Alt F11 will also get us there, so let's go ahead and do that. And now we've opened up, and basically what you're going to see here is a list of sheets here in our time picker. This is our time picker, and this is our new workbook called Book 2. Okay, so our time workbook, and all we want to do is basically take this module here, time picker macros, and we want to drag it into the new workbook, just like that. Okay, and what that's going to do is it's going to basically copy that module into our new workbook. Okay, that's step one. Step two is to click on the sheet one, double click. We're going to double click on this sheet in our time picker. And here on our right side, basically, we have all of the code. This is just the code for its on sheet code, and this helps us launch it. So we're going to do Control A, all, Control A, right, which will basically select all, and Control C. Okay, and then in whichever sheet in our new workbook that we want, in this case, we're going to go with sheet one, we double click on that, okay? And we'll highlight that just so we can replace it because we don't want two optional. And then what I did is Control V. So basically, we're basically copying the code. So we have here, time picker, the same code here, and we have the same code here, okay? And now, but in our, there is a bit of a difference in our new workbook, as if you'll remember, let's go ahead and mention, we want this time to appear in C3, cell C3. So we just have to make a quick change in the code here. And here you see we have K8 from the, we'll make sure we're in the new workbook. We have K8, but we're going to change that to C3. Okay, C3, and that's it. So this was, and if you have multiple cells, we could do C4, C5 if we want it to show up on multiple cells. So we won't need that right now, we'll keep it at C3. Okay, so that's it. Now when we click back into this new workbook, okay, our time picker shows up. All right, so it's pretty simple. Okay, and that's all we have to do. And make sure we save it. And the important thing is when we save that new workbook, okay, we wanna make sure that it's not XLSX means no macros, right? So that's gonna remove our macros. We don't want that. Make sure we do a macro enabled workbook, which is XLSM, okay? When we save it, we wanna make sure we save it as an XLSM. That's really critical because that means macros, M is for macros. So without that, our project won't save properly, okay? So that's very important. And let's assume if you do have some sort of protection on the sheet, or want to make sure within the code, if we go back into the code right here, here I've put some comments in the code. So if it does require protection, you'll have to unprotect it and reprotect it within the code. So here you add any unprotect. So here we would probably, this sheet is protected and we need to unprotect it, we would copy this and we do add, and then we put the password right here, okay? And then we do the same thing for here, okay? Because that's very important. In order for this to work, we need to unprotect it and protect it if your workbook is going to be protected. And that's basically it. It's very simple, straightforward, and that's how you get the time picker into a new workbook. Thank you very much for watching.